Hi friends, I'm Hassan from Educate and you are watching part 3 in our awesome new series Build an Online Business from Scratch with me and reach at least $2,000. In this part, we are going to finish our website setup, install our theme, some plugins, add some pages, so stay tuned and follow up. Okay friends, so this is our website, a WordPress website, and the first step is to install a theme. The theme will give us our website design. We installed this website in part 2, so please, if you haven't watched part 1 and 2, go now and watch it. It's a full connected step-by-step series. Anyway, if you have your website configured, go to the backend WordPress dashboard and then go here to appearance and then themes. You will see now how things is really super simple. Then click on add new to add a new theme, and you will see inside WordPress we have a lot of free themes you can install. Before you install any theme, you have to know something very important. We have two main options. To select one of these themes here, which are somehow free, install and activate on website, or you can go to a website called themeforest.net, where you can find a lot of premium WordPress themes. So it depends on your budget, what you are going to do. You can go here to WordPress and select a category. Let's say in our case, we want something like a blog or something. And you can see a lot of themes here. But anyway, if you plan to go with ThemeForest or to select one of these themes, you have to pay attention to something very important, which is the theme performance. If you go here to Google Page Speed Insight, go here Page Speed Insights, and let's go and open my current website, hdk.com. And let's open any of our articles, copy this link and paste it here and analyze. You can see my page is super fast, and this is very important for SEO, for your website, for your user experience, and much more. We'll talk about website performance later on in a dedicated lecture, but for now, just pay attention. We want to select a theme, make sure to select a fast theme. Now you may tell me how I know this. If you're in ThemeForest, always when you open any of these themes, go and preview it. You can preview it and test it with Google Page Speed Insight, or simply read the reviews, the comments. Just check the theme before you install it. But in our case today, we are going to install a free theme, which is super fast. It's called Neve. And by the way, I'm using Neve in my main website, hdk.com. So I will install this simple, clean, fast theme on our website. Installed and then activate. Of course, you can use another theme if you want. We have also Astra is also fast. We have also Hello Elementor is also fast. We have Ocean WP, Generate Press. All these themes are super fast themes. You can use them if you want. In our case, we'll go with Neve. Now, if we go and refresh our website, you will see it's somehow different. It's super simple. We don't have content now. We will do this later on in the series. But for now, we set up and installed our theme. Just pay attention to performance when you want to install your theme. Let's test this. I will open this article, go here to Google Page Speed Insights again to test our website speed, analyze, and you can see 96 for mobile and 100 for desktop, which is perfect. Now, the second step is to go back to your dashboard and then go here to settings, then permalinks. Permalinks allows you to configure the structure of the URL. Make sure to select post name. This is very important for SEO to get traffic from Google later. So check the post name, then save changes. It says permalink structure updated. And now if you go here to visit our website again and click on Hello World, you will see it is our website name slash the title of the article. This is very important for SEO. If you don't know what is SEO, don't worry, we'll talk about this later in depth. The second step is to go here to the general section in the settings and then make sure to change the tagline if you want. I will keep it empty for now, but what's important here is to set up your website URL. Make sure to use HTTPS and your website name. So whenever someone visits your website, they will get this URL always. Also, this is important for SEO and reaching your website. Save changes. Now let's move on to plugins. In WordPress, we have a lot of plugins, or call it add-ons, that you can add to your website. Today, we are going to install some important plugins Go to plugins here and then go to add new plugin. The first one is called WordFence. This plugin is used to protect your website. It's like a layer of defense to your website. Just go here and activate it. It's super simple. Install and activate this plugin. Very nice. It will take you directly to the wizard. Check this box. Say no here without emails. Enter your email address. Okay, continue. We don't need any premium licenses. Say no thanks. And now we installed WordFence. Let's go to the dashboard. And you can see now we are protected. You can see notification here to complete the setup. Just click here to configure. Then download this user ini configuration file. And then continue and close. And that's it. Now dismiss this notification. And now our firewall WordFence is configured. Super simple. Now go back to plugins again and click on add new to add the second plugin, which is called Updraft. And you can see now Updraft plus WordPress backup plugin. Creating backups for your website is very important. If you lose anything, if anything happens, you can simply restore your data back. So install this plugin so we can run automated backups automatically on your website, and it's free. Activate this. Now go here to this plugin, click on here to start, and you can see now you can backup manually or simply go here to settings and set up automatic backups. Let's say weekly, and let's retain scheduled backups, let's say 3. Then you have to select the storage where you are going to save these files. You can save on AppDraft plus Vault. It's maybe a premium service. You can use Dropbox. You can use your Google Drive free account. Just select whatever you want from here. FTP server, Microsoft OneDrive, anything. And then simply go down and save changes. Now it will automatically tell you to connect. Click on this link. I will use my Gmail account. Okay, allow, complete setup. And here we are, we connected Updraft now to Google Drive. It's that simple. So now our website is protected. It has a firewall and it's protected with backups, with weekly backups. So if anything happens, you can simply restore your data. This is very important. Before we move on, please, if you feel this video is somehow helpful, you got some benefit, don't forget to smash the like button. This will help me grow more on YouTube. And don't forget also to join us on Telegram. I will be there active almost every day. We can chat together, help each other. If you have any questions, anything you want, we will be there to chat together. The link in the description below. Now let's move on to step number 3, adding comment pages. If you go to our website hdk.com, or any website by the way, if you go down, we have these comment pages, privacy policy, terms, and the contact us page. If you go here and say contact, we have this simple contact form. Now we are going to create these 3 pages and you will see how easy it is. I will go here back to my backend, to my dashboard, go here to pages, and let's start with the privacy policy page. Add a new, and then we need to enter a title for our page. Say privacy policy, that's it. Now you may ask from where I will get this privacy policy. Simply go here to our free website, hsupertools.com, and then go here to web tools privacy policy generator. What's your website name? It is embounce. Website URL, just copy it from here and paste it. Generate privacy policy. And you can see now we have HTML version and the text version here. Just scroll down. I will copy everything like this. Control C, then paste here. That's simple. Publish this page. Now let's go back and add a new page, which is a terms page. I will say terms and conditions if you want. And then go back to hsupertools. Again, the same operation. Terms generator. Your URL. Let's copy it. Embounce, and then generate terms. Go down here, copy everything, control C, and then paste here and publish. It is that simple. Later on, of course, we may change some things when we add affiliate links. Maybe we have affiliate disclosures. We will cover everything, don't worry. But for now, this is enough to add the privacy policy and the terms page. If you go here to WordPress and click on this settings icon, you will see in the page section the permalink is terms conditions. So just open this and you will see this is the page now on our website. Very easy. Let's go back, go to privacy policy, edit. This is what we have published. If you go here to the page, you will see that we have privacy policy dash 2. This is somehow a problem because if you go back to our dashboard in the pages section, you will see that we have 2 privacy policy pages. This is by default. default generated by the theme. So I will remove it and then go back here and delete this number 2 and update this page. And now if you go here, view page, privacy policy, and this is our privacy policy page. Awesome and super easy. The last page is the contact us page. Simply go here to plugins, add a new plugin, and then simply search for contact form 7, and you will see now we have contact form 7 plugin. Just install it. You will see how easy it is now. Activate it. You will see now we have the contact section, contact forms. We have the default form. I will just copy this short code, copy, go to pages, add a new page, and I will say here contact us and paste this tag here. It will show you the contact form 1, publish, and now I will click on view page, and you will see this is the contact us page. Super simple and easy. Of course, we can edit this, add some images. We will cover customizing and designing websites later on, but for now, this is enough. We have the contact us page, privacy policy, and terms and conditions. Of course, we don't want them to be stuck in the menu here. We are going to move them later on to the footer section and change our menu and do everything. Don't worry. But for now, this is enough. Now, I want to mention a very important point, so please focus very well. In the last video, I mentioned that we can get $300 credit on Valter so you can test anything you want. This $100 will expire as mentioned inside Valter after 14 days. So after 2 weeks, you will have to pay for hosting. If you don't want to pay for hosting, as I mentioned before, you can go with Blogger. Or today I will give you another coupon for DigitalOcean where you can test $100 for 60 days on DigitalOcean. Or if you want, you can go with Google Cloud and get $300 in free credits to test for 1 year. It's up to you. As I mentioned before, choose whatever hosting company you want. You are not obliged to go with me with Valter. It is just giving you a small coupon to test things. It's up to you anyway. Also, we have a free alternative, which is WordPress.com. Go to WordPress.com, then /new, and you can create an account and create a free WordPress website on WordPress.com. Of course, we'll have some limitations, but it's okay. You can start with, and later on, you can scale up and pay for hosting or switch to another company or whatever you want. This is a very important point you have to consider. And don't forget, please, to join us on Telegram, because everything, all these tips and updates and things, or if you have any bug or announcements, are mentioned in our Telegram channel and group. So please go and join there so we can chat together and help each other. See you in the upcoming video.